as the sun's rising, he's up.
No one goes into the palace without an invitation.
Greetings, Aloy. I am known as Blameless Murad. Please come with me. You're needed for an important consultation.
What do you mean? Where's Erend?
He's inside, attending the Sun King, where we should be without further delay. Follow me, please.
All of these people are here to see the Sun King.
Yes, and each has come to ask a favor of him. Unpleasant, but that's politics. The Sun King is eager to meet you, the machine tamer with a curious eye for detail. It's all very intriguing.
I'm not here to intrigue you.
Too late.
First the Oseram gets special treatment, and now outlandish and savage interests could the Sun King have in her.
Passed by some outlander woman? Unacceptable. I think two animals and this Nora go to the front of the line.
Ignore them. Nobles are like children who whine when they don't get a second helping of dessert.
What's the Sun King like?
The most important thing is what he isn't like. His father. I think you'll find him to be a reasonable man.
Aloy of the Nora, she who sees the unseen, welcome. It would seem you have done me a great service. Erend, tell her what you found.
I checked Ursa's tomb. You were right, Aloy. The body is missing a scar below her right knee. I gave it to Ursa when we were kids, fighting over a toy sword.
If the body is not Ursa's, then we must assume she is still alive. And I will not abandon her.
We only know she was taken, not who took her.
I can help with that. Ursa has an enemy among the Oseram. A warlord named Dervahl.
Impossible. Every clan in the claim has been hunting for him since the liberation. He has to be dead by now.
No other Oseram had the motive and ingenuity to lure Ursa into this trap. I expect to find him lurking somewhere near the border. I've already sent an agent to investigate. He'll be waiting for word from us at the marketplace in Pitchcliff.
I can't move troops to the border without provoking the Oseram. But I could send a few vanguardsmen. And perhaps an exceptionally gifted Nora as well. Erend, Murad, let me discuss it with her privately. I hate to impose further after all you've done, but this is a matter of great importance to me.
It sounds like Ursa means a lot to you.
Without her Oseram vanguard, I would not have been able to liberate Meridian and end my father's brutal reign. Since then, it has been difficult to maintain peace between our tribes. But Ursa has a way of making her people see reason. So you see, I need her back at my side. And quickly.
Who is Dervahl exactly?
To understand Dervahl, you must first understand my father. He truly thought of himself as a sun god. His mind was broken. He believed that blood sacrifice would solve, well, everything. So he raided the other tribes for victims, especially the Oseram. Dervahl fought back. He crafted powerful weapons and rallied his people. My father responded with the ultimate cruelty. He captured Dervahl's wife and daughter and sacrificed them in the Sun Ring.
So why would Dervahl go to so much trouble to kidnap Ursa?
He felt she betrayed him. She fought by his side until she realized he planned to raise Meridian and butcher its people. And she came to me. Together, we stopped him and liberated the city from my father. Dervahl has spent every moment since trying to get revenge. Mostly on the other Oseram who fought with us. He made so many powerful enemies. I thought we'd seen the last of him. I was wrong.
The killers who attacked the Nora. I've discovered that they're a faction of Shadow Carja called the Eclipse. They're digging up ancient weapons. Machines that corrupt and control other machines. They want to use them to strike Meridian.
What you're saying echoes reports I've received from Murad. A Shadow Carja splinter group. Corrupted machines across the land. When will this attack come, do you know?
I'm not exactly sure.
Then we will do what we can to prepare. But in the meantime, Ursa is my highest priority. Please, help me find her.
I'd like to ask you something about the Sundom and its politics.
By all means.
They call you a sun god who killed his own father in order to unite the tribes in harmony. Is any of it true?
They say you can see the invisible, split an arrow at 50 paces, and tame machines at a glance. How much of that is true?
It's not too far off.
Well, I would like to unite the tribes in harmony, but you saw how many courtiers I have to deal with first. Maybe next week.
Quite a place you've got here. You can almost see the little people below the mesa.
You don't approve? Well, I have a secret for you. Neither do I. But we must be patient. Change won't come in a single sunrise.
But will it happen at all, while men live in palaces?
It might. Eventually. If people like you help me bring it about.
Your politics seem very complicated. The Oseram are friends, but enemies too?
I couldn't have liberated Meridian without the help of Ursa and her Oseram freebooters. Many of them have settled here. But the Ealdermen of the Oseram clans and the Claim have become jealous of their success. So have many Carja nobles. It's a volatile situation, especially given the fact that my father raided the Oseram for years. Ursa helps keep the peace, promising a future based on mutual gain. But some, like Dervahl, will never let go of their venom.
What can you tell me about the Shadow Carja? What do they have to do with Ursa?
They are remnants of my father's regime, holding out at the fortress of Sunfall to the west. Like him, they care only for domination, and seek to draw upon the power of the sun by spilling blood in its name. Since Ursa helped me take this city from them, they were perfect scapegoats. Dervahl knew this, of course, and planned it well.
I need to get going.
I know. Well, they say kings should never beg. But please, help me find Ursa.
Who says that?
Well, Murad, for one. Don't hesitate to ask him or Erend if you have further questions. What do you need, Aloy?
I have to go.
Understood.
don't need to loiter around here.
So, I thought Ersa was dead, and I thought Dervahl was dead. Dead doesn't seem to mean what it used to. Or maybe I'm just an ass. Whatever. All I know is that it's time to find my sister and get some payback. I hope Murad's guy grabs us the lead.
Did Ersa ever tell you anything about Dervahl?
Well, we were both under his command for a while. Sort of. Helped him recruit an army to take out the mad Sun King. But then he got real creepy with Ersa. Needless to say, she wasn't interested, but he wouldn't let it go. Not to mention the fact that we realized he wanted to murder every Karja, not just the bad ones. Long story short, he's a grazer-licking dumbag.
Avad seems committed to finding your sister.
Yeah, those two got along. And some people say they shacked up, but I don't buy it. Seems a little skinny for her. Oh, okay, some bad images are forming in my head. Let's just focus on finding her. And kicking Dervahl's ass.
I'd better go.
Don't stand me up in Pitchcliff, okay? Ersa needs us.
Aloy, how can I be of service?
It's obvious that you're an advisor to the Sun King, but what is it you do exactly?
Whatever is needed, of course.
Are you always so evasive?
It depends.
You were right about Avad. He seems genuine.
He is the Sun King. I serve him the best I can. What else would you have me say?
Huh. Did you serve the last one as best you could, too?
Well, I served him. To his enemies. It was the best I could do for the Sundom.
What did you do?
Nothing I could be blamed for.
Sounds to me like you're a spy.
There are many helpful voices in the Sundom and beyond. I like to think of myself as a good listener.
So why do they call you Blameless Murad?
Well, it depends on who you mean by they. And what they might wish to blame me for.
Talking to you is tiring.
So they say.
What will I find at the border?
An outpost full of Oseram, most of whom want nothing to do with Dervahl. Still, he inspires great loyalty in those who fought with him against the last Sun King. He will not be caught alone. And don't forget, he is a master craftsman. Nothing delights him more than his dangerous toys.
What makes you so sure Dervahl did this to Ersa?
I don't care for sure or certain. I prefer likely or probably. How many Oseram are clever enough for this ruse?
capable of building the weapon you described, who hate Ersa so. More than one? Not likely. Dervahl? Quite probably.
Even if people think he's dead?
That is surely another reason to be suspicious of certain words.
I have to go.
Then you must.
I'll find it. Use for you. Need them soon enough. Now.
I'd shake your hand, but mine's at the forge.
The snow's got a bite out here.
Hate the rain, hate the rust.
This must be Pitchcliff. Murad's agent should be at the marketplace by now. Thank you.
this rusts the body's joints.
No sign of Marat's guy? He's had plenty of time to investigate.
We'd better look for him.
Damn right.
Smoke and sweat. That's how you know you've done a good day's work.
More tracks. I think someone followed whoever we're following.
That sounds bad.
Has to be Marat's guy. Durval's thugs must have made him.
Maybe because he found something. Look at this. I think he drew a map with his own blood.
Right. Those kind of maps, you know you'd better follow.
That might be Pitchcliff. He marked a spot to the north. Could be Durval's location.
My men are waiting outside of town. I'll grab them and meet you there.